Hello! Phyllis the Great Turtle here, and welcome to a dream vlog. This is something I've been wanting to do. I've been kind of toying with it, you know, on the sideline here. This is something I think I want to do for a lot of different reasons. And basically what this will be is me talking about the dreams I've had. That's basically... And I don't want to limit it to just ones that are like, well, I mean, they're always going to be in the past, okay? It's not like I'm going to be able to tell you about a dream while I'm having a dream. I just don't work that way, okay? but all the ones in the past. Why left is the past, I don't know. Anyways, we're going to talk about dreams. And I don't want to limit to ones that are like really far back, but like literally, I have dreams as long as I'm not woken up by an alarm clock. Or something like that, if I'm allowed to wake up on my own, I'll have a dream, and I'll be able to remember it. If I have to get up and get going right away, it'll be gone. If I have to, you know, reach over and hit the alarm, I'll lose most of the dream. But I have a dream every day, or at least one dream every day. I will then record each of those every day, but I'm going to probably put out the video once a week. I'm thinking right now on a Friday. I'll put out the video every Friday. Not awake Phyllis the Great Turtle will record the dreams that he's had. And let me tell you, he is not awake. I just like went and watched one of them because I tried it out just to see it. Went and watched one of them like, so guys were just... Yeah, and like, you gotta keep in mind, this is me with my hair combed, like, when I get up in the morning, it's like, if we want to throw professionalism out the window, he can present all of them to you, but he is not awake. It's somewhat funny, I don't know if it's funny enough, and I don't know if I'm comfortable enough to let not awake me come out and do that, but maybe, if you guys want to see that, we should talk about the kind of person I am with dreams. I'm not a lucid dreamer, yet I am. I don't really lucid dream anymore. I used to do it all the time because I had nightmares all the time. So I would control it, you know. It's like, oh crap, that thing's scary. It's time to wake up. Poof. Wake myself up, which has resulted in at least one of the more scarier moments in my life where I woke up, but I didn't wake up. And so I knew I was lying in my bed, looking at the inside of my eyelids, and I couldn't move. And I was absolutely terrified. I was hoping somebody would come in and wake me up, because I knew I wasn't all the way awake yet. You know, it was not fun. Or changing dreams, or doing things differently. But since I don't really have nightmares anymore, it's just kind of, I watch the dreams and watch them unfold. And there's almost always a coherent storyline. Sometimes they're a little weird. And sometimes what's going on in the dream doesn't make a lick of sense, but there's a storyline behind it. But I as long as I'm given a chance to remember them, I will have at least one dream, and they usually have a lot more. And I can never remember the beginning of them. I can always remember the end to the middle, maybe. Maybe the middle. Usually it's just the end. So, we'll talk about the ones I had this morning. And then we'll share some of the cooler ones, what I can remember of them. And talk about some other dream stuff. So this one will probably be a longer episode. Not sure if I'm going to share names. Maybe I'll just do first names of people. Unless it's some popular person, then I'll be like, yeah, no, I had so-and-so in my dream. And this is what they were doing. Without further ado, let us begin. So, I had three dreams this morning, but they're kind of all... Because I got woken up. Because I forgot to leave the keys in the car, so I was woken up, hey, where are the keys? So that dream kind of got shattered. And then I had another one, and I went back to sleep. Alarm went off, that dream got shattered too. So, the first one, and I always like dreams like this. I'm always particularly attached to dreams where I'm getting to hang out with people. Whether these are people that I haven't seen in years, people I have crushes on, people who, you know, when I'm hanging out with people. I just enjoy those. Those are some of my best dreams, actually. What I do remember is I was hanging out, like, standing next to, like, the crush of my life, all right? I mean, it's the only woman who I have, like, literally had the crush on. Like, time slowed down when she walked by. Like, I still genuinely believe that she might have been the one and I was too chicken to say anything. That level of crush. So I'm hanging out with her and talking to her, and I don't remember the details of it, but it was cool and it was weird at the same time, because, like, I'm talking to her and somehow, like, we got talking about different things, and then at one point or another she's stroking my beard as I'm, like, looking at the people walking by, and she's just, like, stroking my beard. I'm like, And this is totally true to character. Like, if somebody starts stroking my beard, and as long as you don't, like, smell bad, as long as your hand doesn't smell terrible, or you're not being exceptionally weird with it, because, you know, just walking up and stroking my beard is weird enough, I'll just be kind of like, all right, okay, then, I'm just gonna let this go. Maybe you'll stop. Yeah, she's like stroking my beard, and this isn't, like, a sexual thing at all. It's just like, you know, huh. I don't know if she was like, it's so soft, because if she was, my dreams are lying to me. Well, they're mostly lying to me. don't judge me. I'm shaking my camera. Don't judge me. And like, I don't remember all the details, but the weird part about it is, like, we're standing around, like, one of those big trash cans. Well, the trash can itself wasn't weird. But it's like one of the square ones with just the open top. Sometimes they have a little spinny thing on top of them, but they're just the open top. Which makes sense, because the job I work at, I see those all the time. Yeah, that could be in there. And then she puts this, like, big box on top of it. Like, it manages to just barely extend all the way across it. Well, so the box is sitting there. This is the order. The box is sitting there, and we're talking. I don't know if she stroked my beard at this point or later. But the weird part about it is we're, like, standing. I'm facing it. She's standing, like, right over here, kind of facing it at an angle. And then it, like, turns into a fridge. It turns into my mini fridge. And, like, I reach down and open up the bottom half of it and pull out my drinks and start drinking them. And it's like, wait, that's a trash can, too. So is my mini fridge, like, under the trash bag? Or am I pulling these out of the trash and drinking them and they're just refrigerated magically? I don't know. And then, like, her box breaks, and me being a good old guy, I managed to catch it. You know, hey, cool, whatever. And then I'm like, oh, we should close it. And so the trash can magically changes into one of the ones that you'd leave out by the road, and I put the lid closed and put the thing on top of it. And I don't really remember it. I enjoyed that one just because she was in it, all right? You know? We were talking. Something we've never done. I'm sad and pathetic, I know. And then, that's really all I remember of that one. And I think, yeah, that was the one that I had second, I think. The first one, being attacked by zombies. I'm missing a whole bunch of the stream. Like I said, I got woken up. Being attacked by zombies. And, you know, I'm killing zombies, but here's the thing. My mind in the dream is like, oh, they're zombies. We've got to stop them. They're going to bite us. We're going to become zombies. We got to kill them. All right. But when you're looking at them in the dream, they look like normal people. There's not any rotten flesh, and they're not going, ah, they're just kind of, you know, marching toward us. There was me and somebody else. Briefly, there was somebody else behind me, because we're, like, standing in a doorway fighting back these zombies. All right. They look like little normal people. And if I remember correctly, I think at least the whole front row, if not all of them, were women. And so I'm killing zombies. At least that's what my mind's telling me. So I'm killing zombies, and at one point, like, one of them, like, looks at me, and is just like, you can see my face? And I immediately respond, without hesitation, yes, and soon I'll see your zombie face. And then I think I, like, immediately reach out and just snap her neck. Keep in mind, she's a zombie, so it's okay. And don't worry, we're gonna have a long talk about this one. We go, and then it proceeds on, and, like, all of a sudden I become, like, a third-person camera. And I'm watching who I assume was the person behind me. They, like, finish off the zombies. It's like, I don't remember getting bit or anything. I'm a third-person camera now. I don't know. It'd be this, wouldn't it? Quit moving me around with a joystick. I don't know. And then there's like a voice that says something to her, and this woman was either, I'm not sure because I didn't get a good look at the person, but either it was like a famous actress in a black dress that looked more like a nightgown, or somebody who I wasn't really good friends with, but I did know for a little bit, who was in that actress's black dress that looked more like a nightgown. Anyways, they, I guess, finished all the zombies off, and the voice was just like, hey, I'm gonna send somebody to give you a gift. And then, because you've killed all the zombies, or something like that. And then, that person, that woman, you know, lays down, and after resting for a little bit, a little zombie child comes up to the side of her bed, and she manages to react fast enough and get, like, the bed sheets between her and the zombie, and then, like, breaks the little kid's neck. I mean, the little zombie's neck. Because keep in mind, none of these people look like zombies. And then she gets, like, some sort of, like, yellow pill. Maybe it wasn't a pill, but it was, like, that big, maybe. And it was yellow. That was all I remember. And that was the gift, I guess. And then she goes through the doorway and then, like, immediately changes into Wayne Brady. Who then Wayne Brady runs over to this table. There's somebody sitting at it. I didn't catch the gender. There's just somebody sitting there in a chair. There's the little table and a chair across from him. And on the table, there's like a martini glass. And Wayne Brady runs over and throws the little yellow thing in the martini glass and sits in the chair. And then the dream ends. And it's left me with more questions than answers. I think it was some sort of, like, game save mechanic? I really don't know. I'm a little bit more concerned with the beginning of the dream, that I can remember anyways, of the killing of the zombies. Of a specific gender. So like, that's troublesome in and of itself. And then looking back at it, you can see my face? Yes, but soon I'll see your zombie face. Does not fit with that dream at all. It really doesn't. Like, it just seems so out of place. And that gets me to something I want to bring up in this little episode here. Have you ever had a dream that has had somebody in it? And then if you've gotten to talk to that person, and they'd be like, yeah, no, I had that dream. Have you ever shared a dream with somebody? That happened to me, with one of my best friends. He, in the dream, I don't remember all the details, it was fuzzy even then, but I was in a car with a few other people, and we were driving down the road, and I, like, leaned out the window or something, and then a car that was coming the opposite direction, my best friend was in it, and we, like, waved at each other or something, and he was in a car with, like, three other people, too. And then, like, I go a little ways and my dream ends. It's just over. His dream basically starts right where he waves at me, and he went on and then got out of the car. Maybe, like, a fight or something happened, and then I think they got back in the car. I don't remember. But it's like, literally, he called me later that day after having that dream. I didn't contact him, you know, just I had that dream, and he called me to talk to me. And then it was like, oh, hey, that's cool. I had a dream about you earlier today. He's like, I had a dream about you. and we shared it, and our dreams, like, synchronized. Now, I mean, so I suppose that he could be lying to me, which would break my poor little dreamy heart, because, I honestly believe there is, like, another level, if you will, to dreams. I do believe it's possible, more than just, like, the coincidence of, well, yeah, you have a lot of dreams, so it was bound to happen sooner or later. I do believe it's possible for people to share dreams, if that makes sense at all. Probably doesn't, I tend to ramble on. And that's one thing that this dream vlog, I mean, it's a video, alright, will serve. It will allow me to say, hey, I had a dream about so-and-so. Hey, so-and-so, did you have a dream about me? We can put to rest that, if you can't fall asleep, it's because you're awake in somebody's dream. Myth thing. You know, put that to rest. I don't know. So I just want to share them because I like talking about dreams. The third dream I had was just a simple little thing that all I remember is there was some sort of contest going on. And I think my oldest sister was presiding over it as some sort of judge. And I had to, like, I was sitting on, like, one of the benches, and I had to, like, leave and go to, like, somewhere else, because that's technically where contestants should sit, and I wasn't a contestant. And then, there was a lot of people in there, too. And then two people started fighting over a project, and it was like a Star Wars project, and, like, from here over was, like, part of the battle for Tatooine. What is it called? The one where Jar Jar Binks is from. Where Princess Amidala, right? That city, it was in that city. The battle is, like, this part is the fight in the city, and this is inside one of the buildings, and, like, the two people fought over it, and the one person, like, tore it off, and they ended up taking basically just the battle outside in the city plaza areas, and the other person was left with what was inside. And they were upset about it, and the other person stormed off, and then my sister started singing a song that was... It was sung to the tune of Happy Birthday. And it was something like... It literally used what we just saw and basically described it in words. And it wasn't particularly funny, but everyone else thought it was funny. And, you know, looks like they lost the Battle of Tatooine in song form or something. I don't know. That Tatooine was said in there somewhere, which... in hindsight, probably doesn't make sense. And I figure as I share more dreams that I'm having now, I'll share some of the older ones along the way, rather than getting them all out in one video. But to share with you two of the dreams that exemplify the whole I can have coherent plot lines in my dreams, and I've only had two like this, alright? So the first one, what happens at the beginning of the dream is there's a car accident. Is, you know, it's like I got my parents, and I don't think they're my real parents as in real life parents, I think they're just random placeholder parents in the dream, but my parents get into a car accident and they both die, but me, the little baby boy, survives unscathed. You know, and then I grow up to become some sort of researcher. I get a crush on this girl, and she starts doing research into something, and she takes off after it, and I think she was researching into my parents' death, into my past, but she takes off chasing a lead, basically, and me, you know, feeling the need to protect her and her being a crush, follow her. And she ends up coming back to the location where my parents' car went off the road and they both died. And then across the street, basically, it's more country-ish, but a little ways into the, you know, there's a mansion. That looks more like your haunted mansion kind of thing. And I either think or I know she went in there. And for some reason or another, I have cops chasing me. There are cops following in on my trail. I'm following hers, the cops are following mine. And I do believe that the cops thought I killed her or something, and so they're following me. But I'm not sure. Anyways, I go up to this mansion, and I get inside, and I go, and I'm looking around for her. I think I call out for her, maybe. I go downstairs, like, open the basement, and I think the basement, when I open the door, it, like, opens up from like the haunted style, it just opens up to like a men's locker room, like you'd see at your high school or something. And I think I immediately just go, oh, nope, and I close the door. It's like a complete change. It's like from dimly lit to well lit and hot and smelly. All right, close. And then I don't think it smelled. It was well lit, though. And then I go up the stairs. The cops are banging on the door now trying to get in. I think they like managed to get a hole through the door, or the door already had a hole in it, and they're trying to grab the doorknob. So I run upstairs. They're coming in now. And I go upstairs, and I run into, like, I run up and I go into, like, the master bedroom, and I close the door, and I somehow barricade it or lock it. My viewpoint switches to that of one of the police officers who I think was my friend, and they, like, the door starts to swing open, they get it open, and they're calling out for me, and when they open the door, boom, in that room, there's nothing but this monster, and I don't remember what it looked like, but it wasn't human anymore. I think it might have had arms, but it wasn't human anymore. And it attacks, and it knocks out of the way. I think it kills some of the officers, but it doesn't kill the guy who is my friend, that officer. And I, like, it runs downstairs, and I think I switch to its viewpoint. But I'm not sure. It's really kind of fuzzy. I go outside, and this officer chases the monster, and there's this woman who claims to have made me. I'm her pet, her monster, the monster, and I think I'm in the viewpoint of the monster, claims to have made me, and reveals that the car crash wasn't actually a car crash. They stopped outside this mansion for one reason or another, and I got out, and I threw a temper tantrum, and she, like, grew the evil in my heart and, like, gave me super strength. My parents didn't die in the car crash. I killed them. I flipped the car onto them, or I flipped the car with them in it. And I'm, like, reliving this memory. She's, like, forcing me to relive this memory, and this cop is watching this, like, whole memory unfold. Alright? And I, like, they were, like, in the car when I flipped it. Little tiny me just, woof, flips the car and it kills him. That from the very beginning, she's been trying to turn me into a monster, into her minion. And she's been working at it, and the girl was baited into coming here, because then I would follow her and she could get me back and, like, turn me. And I don't remember if anything else happened after that, but that was the plot twist. My parents didn't die in a car crash. I killed them. And then this one's my particular favorite, and this one I remember rather well. There was a sea monster. Now, the setting was a little weird. We were in, like, a Greek, what do they call them, Odeons? Basically the steps that go up, and then there's, like, a plaza in the middle where the person talks and sends out the... Except in that plaza in the middle was, like, water. So kind of what you'd expect to see at, like, you know, some big giant aquarium with the stand. Bleachers up, and then... And it was killing people, it was taking people, and everyone tried to fight it. Nobody could, everyone would die. It would take them, I don't know if it ate them or just killed them or whatever. A little, like, tentacle, like, you know, Kraken style. Into the water. And then my mother was in this dream, and she found, and her and I found out, or she found out that... like holy water or just water. I think it was like a holy water or something. Based on some ancient text or something, this creature's weak to it. That, you know, it mentions splashing this holy water on it or whatever. And she does this and it doesn't do anything. And it kills her. She dies. And I live, and I look into it a little bit more. I manage to find out there's a book that's what made the monster. You splash this holy water on the book, it kills the monster. So, whoever it was, and I don't remember anymore, this person that I'm with, they do this, and it kills the monster, but then the book, which, like, when you read it, like, the first time, like, the very front page is talking about the monster, and it says so-and-so became the monster. we'll use... It says, John became the monster, his arms extended to tentacles, whatever, right? Well, the person who threw water onto it, it changed to their name. It started writing the text again, but then it was their name. So rather than John, it was Jim. You know? Jim became the monster. And I'm watching it start to type this in, and it's affecting my buddy or whatever. So, I grab the book, and I don't know if I got a pen or pencil, and I scribble it out and write my name in. And every time it goes to use him, I put myself in there. So I slowly become the monster. You figure out that you can kill the monster, but there's always going to be one. Whoever kills the monster becomes the next one. And that one I thought was really cool. But that's what I mean when I say my dreams can have coherent plots. They usually have coherent plots. But I think that'll be all I put in for this one. And then the next dreams I have, I'll put those up. I'm going to try to do it every week, so I'll stockpile up, 7 days worth of dreams or so. I mean, it's a Thursday now when I'm recording this, so maybe I'll do it every Friday. Let me know what you guys think of this, if you want to see more, or if you want to hear particular kinds of dreams that I have. I've had quite a few, and I'd love to talk about them. I could talk for hours about dreams. I would bore us all. So, thank you all for watching, and maybe I'll see you in the next video. Toodaloo!